5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team ban. Team secrets turn to ban.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back after a nice intermission of about an hour and a half's time. We are in series number two today. It's Team Secret going against CIS Rejects, and by the end of the series, we will know who is going to be slotted where into Group B. Now, before we head into the introductions, I do want to clarify exactly where we stand in this tournament. I know there's been some confusion. We're currently working our way into, well, Group B right now, as you can see. Actually, I don't want to put all those out there, but this is very important right now for Secret. They need to at least get a 2-0 win here to have a chance to at least get themselves into a second place position. Because if they get a 2-0, that means they tie up with Liquid and they will go into a best of one tiebreaker for that second place position. Now, I don't know if that tiebreaker is going to be happening today or on a different date. I'm sure that will be discussed at the time when necessary. But if Secret don't at least get one win, they will definitely be put into that fourth place position and will have to fight from the last chance bracket. And, well, on the other side, we have CIS Rejects. You know, for them personally, they would love to be able to at least secure two wins. Obviously, they need the two wins to at least secure a second place position. So, very important series here. It's about to get underway. I'm Coddle Guy for Beyond the Summit. I'm going to be joined once again from Clairvoyance. Clairvoyance, sorry about the long break, but hopefully you're back here and now and hyped up for some Secret versus CIS Rejects.
Oh, no, please don't apologize for that break. Took my time and charged up, as they say.
Perfect, perfect. So what are our impressions coming into this matchup? How are we feeling about Secret? They have not even won a series yet here in Star Ladder. You got to remember, they went up against that Liquid matchup recently. They got a taste of their own medicine when Kuro was doing the mid lane pull of Wisp. They tried to do that crazy first draft, first phase pickup of Huskar without having a Dazzle. You know, what can we expect today from Secret? Is it try hard mode for them, or is it still, who knows?
Well, I really think Secret, you can, most of the time, you can expect the tryhard mode. Reserve for sure. Whether their performance implies it or not is always a different question, because this team is very volatile in what they can do and what they do. But Radiant for now, they have a very standard set of picks with the Shadow Fiend as well as the Darkseer. So, very least, for the time being, you can expect them to go hard. Try hard.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I'm sure they're very happy. Shadow Fiend's always a popular pick for them. Most recently, we'll see, you know, Weehaw pick that up, but we always have to pull out that slight option that if an audible is necessary, Envy himself can pick it up in the safe lane. It is interesting to see. Secret just tend to really have a bad rap with the hero altogether, or it must be. They ban out the Huskar already in the second phase. I guess, you know, with Dazzle still out there as a possible option, we could likely see CIS, you know, go for the Dazzle Huskar 1-2 in this next phase, so I guess it's better to play safe. Broodmother's got to be something always to throw out there, but there is already a commitment to the Darkseer and Secret, so I guess that's less likely. I guess I just got a little Brood happy because it was such a good performance from Phobos in the last series. But moving forward here, Secret, they will eliminate the Gyrocopter, typically a comfort pick and something a lot of these CIS teams really love to go crazy with.
Yeah, yeah. I like how you particularly pointed out the CIS teams. They're really the ones that pick it very often. As a comfort pick, as well as something that synergizes with their lineups most of the time. I mean, to be fair, Gyrocopter synergizes with, like... Yeah, so Secret's gonna pick up the Ancient Apparition now. So, it's decent lane support against the Star, of course. And as the game progresses, it's a hero that doesn't want to be in the fight. And Slaughter and Bane most certainly going to be in the middle of the fray there, so you can catch on from the aerial assault of the Ancient Apparition. It's a certain piece critical to their arsenal.
And we don't really get to see the hero picked up unless it's an obvious direct counter. Having it picked up now doesn't seem to be doing much against the current lineup of CIS Rejects, though, the nice thing is that for these next three picks, their hero pool does kind of change a bit. You know, options that might have been plausible before now are not going to be a smart idea once Secret grab up something like this AA. Does add a lot to Team Secret's level one fight if they do want to contest, you know, for a rune fast. Maybe this could be for getting themselves an alchemist or something. You know, we'll have to see. But I do love it. You know, the hero has been buffed up a bit. His cold feet now has a ridiculous 1,000 range. Could be very useful against someone like Bane, who's just trying to hide in the back and getting a fiend's grip off. But look at this follow-up grab now from CIS. Another, you know, this is feeling very vanilla bean for the meta right now. Windranger coming in for them.
Right. And under normal circumstances, I would expect the Windranger to be on the Secret side, the Wii App picking that up, and Shadow Fiend usually on the other. But in this case, not so. As you mentioned with the Cold Feet, it's a lot of range coming out of Secret still. Of course, Slaughter, Bane, pretty decent range, and Windranger with the Slaughter, assuming that they're going to go for Blink Dagger initiations, they're going to be pretty strong in that regard as well. Really interested to just... Really, thought behind the Huskar ban. I don't know, it's like CIS Rejects have really good picks against the Huskar. And Team Secret, looking at the Ancient Apparition, as you said, it's an Alchemist potential, but I'm not too sure if they would have been worried about the Huskar either, but regardless, it is still one ban. I guess we have one more pick left to go before we get back into the deep process of the ban and the pick. And as you mentioned, man, I think Alchemist is it's a possible option, but I don't think they're going to go for it here. It's going to be pretty tough against Slaughter and Windranger.
Yeah, Envy's not going to have the luxury this time, it looks like, of getting that precious Ember Spirit, which he seems to be just unstoppable with. They did get him that one win yesterday, but they still dropped the series ultimately altogether against, I believe it was, what, Vega? Yeah, Vega. So now they just really need a win, so they got to go with just what works. Maybe not going too risky business here. And it was something I was calling out the other past couple of days, whenever I see a Darkseer, it just always used to be in tandem getting something like this. Spiritbreaker coming in for Team Secret now, and this can allow him to really impose his will. A very aggressive kind of stance he could take. Pileidai usually more on the, you know, secretive, little, you know, frustrating kind of heroes, but this time he's going to have to be a bruiser. And we already know, you get him something like Chilling Touch plus an Ion Shell, he's going to be a force to reckon with.
There's certainly going to be a lot of buffs to complement a Spirit Breaker that's going in. It was like a teamfight breakout. As you mentioned, I think with the lane setups, it's going to be Darkseer, Spirit Breaker in the offlane, just dual laning aggressively against the potential lineup coming out of CIS Reject. Now, they do have a Bane. Of course, there is no Dazzle, and there has been no investment for that fourth support pick yet. If they opt for the Bane-Dazzle combination, it's also very defensive and very strong against all sorts of aggression in the early stages. So might have to be wary of that. Of course, they do have the Ancient Apparition, which is like a steady counter to the Dazzle as well.
Yeah.
See what they go for here.
Maybe they pass over that. You get something like a Rubick. I don't know if they have a big, you know, Rubick player for... Oh, they do. Always Want to Fly used to play a lot of Rubick for Empire,
right.
So that is
Sand
possible.
Sand King, Rubick.
Sand King, yeah, Rubick. Would be very good to stop the Spirit Breaker for coming in. Lots of great spells to even steal in this one. Hell, Ice Blast. We already know Requiem is always a quick option. But I'm sure it's something they're thinking about, and they want to preserve their safe lane pick, I'd imagine, for the end. Both teams are right now, kind of taking this, that same approach to the draft. So we got to start thinking about even the plausible options of what they're going to have to be going against in the late game here. Do you think with the lineup that Secret have between these four picks, they're going to want to get something for Envy that's more fight heavy? You know, maybe like a PL. Also, PL could be something CIS or going for themselves, by the way, but you know, fight heavy, or are they going to look to try to take it longer and pull out something like an AM, let's say? Disruptor.
I think AM is kind of risky, especially now with the disruptor pick. It's like one additional lockdown slash guaranteed kill on the anti. I do think they're going to go for that style though, where they scale better, play aggressively, and I'll just try to exploit the farm around the map kind of thing. They already have Darkseer to push out lanes, and Shadow Fiend's going to be farming the woods. So yeah, I definitely imagine Envy's not going to be stuck on a hero that's too stale or immobile. Bear is out, but Queen of Pain, who knows?
Ooh. That's a bit peculiar, that ban right there, Sven. I mean, your first flag is possibly, are they really going to try to creep in maybe a Meepo or something? Or they could be just simply going for the PL themselves. That might be a hot grab here. And Secret do have the next pick. I don't know, that just seems a bit peculiar to me. Taking out a hero like Sven just leads me to believe that it's directly for this pick right here now.
Yeah.
Rejects think it's the Meepo. PL could be the next option. There it is.
Definitely, like, they were wary of the cleave, and of course, CIS rejects again. They have a lot of single target heroes this time. So it looks like PL is going to be that hero that scales better, and it's going to try to take advantage of the farm that's around the map and push in the meantime as well.
So what do you get for rejects now to help against this PL?
Oh, I think reject strategy is it's quite sound, I feel, honestly. I don't think they should feel too pressured about it. Okay. Again, they have a lot of single target, so what they want to do is just add on something that can fight a little bit more, and I think Juggernaut's actually
Yeah. I was going to say the same thing the same time as you. Juggs offers great mid-game there. There he is, man. Woo, we got it. I love it.
I mean, like it's like the only option left. To be completely honest, I don't really believe in it that much. It's like a... Against Ancient Apparition, Healing Word, the effectiveness of this spell is not as great, of course. And you are dealing with a Shadow Fiend, who's going to get probably more farm. It's something that they needed here.
Shadow Fiend is going to get a lot of farm, could fight a lot sooner than the Wind Ranger. Jug and his Precious Ward might have a bit of difficulty. You got AA on the other side, so the sustained power may not be there for him as easy. But, this is one of those games where, I agree, both teams have a pretty sound lineup. It's just going to come down to how well the laning stage goes, the execution, and who's going to be able to take that kind of advantage and be able to transition it from one phase to the other, from early game to mid game, and be able to hold on to it. I don't see a lot of throws typically from these teams like Secret from... we've seen so far, usually when they have that bad start, they will tend to finish out with a bad ending. But when they have a good start, they're not a team very often to throw it away. Not as of recent. So it's going to be very important here at the early start. Look how important it is. Both teams early TP in now. They scout out Pileidai rushing through and behind. They're going to see this one. Always want to fly. Already put the ward down in the lane even. And this is just going to be an easy ward takedown. But nothing going to be coming easy, and as you said, it is going to be most likely that Spirit Breaker Darkseer duo down here. maybe.
Yeah, maybe. After all this right-click engagement here, as well as the ward probably getting denied out, I'm not sure how they want to take this now. Because now the pull will be available, and of course the lane setup's already prepared for the side of CIS rejects. They have the lane ward, and we'll have to just see the progression of the rune, see what happens with bounties.
And it doesn't look like we're going to have too much confrontation here. At the start, it looks like CIS will be able to take over the bottom. And it's going to be Secret to grab the top. So people just coming in right now, welcome Star Series 13. This is going to be our last series today. And our last series probably for a while. It will depend, of course, if there's going to be tiebreakers or not. But after today, we're going to find out exactly what teams have secured their spot to go to Belarus at the LAN. And, well, for the others remaining, the bottom two of each group, they will have to battle it out in a four-team single elimination bracket for the last chance. Only one team will come out to get that final spot to go to the LAN. And, well, Secret here and now will definitely need both wins to have a chance to get second place through a tiebreaker. Otherwise, they drop one game, they are definitely in fourth.
Here we go with the infamous dual lane middle.
Only on one side this time. No backup coming in quite yet here. Misery is nearby, but this is what looks like straight to jungle Darkseer. All right. Iron Shells do last longer. That is a nice thing for him, so he can easily get out two, maybe even three at times. So that's nice.
I guess he was sort of wary of the Juggernaut Disruptor combo. Disruptor is definitely one of the best leading supports against Darkseer, because you can just pull him back after he surges away. And Juggernaut, of course, he can just spin through the Iron Shell and do damage to you in the process.
And so it's better to just get some farm somewhere at some time. Don't put yourself into a position where you're going to be getting nothing at all, plus splitting the XP between you and a Pileidai. No, just let Pi sit down there. He's going to accept the fact that he's probably not going to be getting a whole lot. Any CS he gets is a win for him, but otherwise just getting that free solo XP when possible. He has plenty of regen to kind of chew through here, and he should be able to do it, but we might be seeing the consequences here mid lane already. Look at Weeha, still 0-0 CS right now. Windranger at 5-4, man. This is not a solid start for Wee. We saw from yesterday, getting those lanes denied, he really cares about how his mid lane phase goes.
Yeah, this is actually quite a good job being done by Goldblack. He's already picked up level 2 on Goldblack here, and he's harassing Weeha so much. Forcing out the solve alone as a support, this is a huge win for CIS rejects at mid, and I feel like Secret, they really need to start paying attention to this.
I mean, and it's his birthday apparently, so quick shout out to Goblack. Happy birthday to you. And he is gifting we all one hell of a laning phase right now. This is just unforgiving, as he just is the birthday bully at this point, keeping him back and at bay. And I agree with you, at some point something may need to be done, and I don't know who it's going to be. You know, really, Pilot Eye can't just ditch bottom. It might be
Puppy.
Yeah, Puppy gets crushed up, it looks like here. He's going to eat a few right clicks. Sprint's already out. Envy has to step in and dish out a Spirit Lance to keep him back, and he will stay back. Back at bottom lane, Misery has reappeared. Once he got to his level 2, he's actually level 3 now. He joins in the lane again, and they might be able to get Always Want to Fly. And oh, that Iron Shell Creep just walks up and gives him a little hug, and that's going to be enough to take him down. Secret are going to get the first blood and put themselves on the board.
Yeah, nicely done. Nice movement by Misery coming in after clearing a couple of jungle stacks. And now Weeha's going to grab the Invis rune at bottom, but he's still level 2. He had to ferry in an extra solve. In the meantime, Iceberg at the middle line. 14-11. Oh my goodness, this is not fair.
Oh man, Puppy again doing a little bit of that do-side-do, trying to get away, but the sprint is on an Afterlight. This guy loves playing Slardar, and oh, he's not able to get the connection there. One more right-click would have done it, but Puppy's going to be fine, and he will walk away with his life. He will have to limp his way all the way back to base with only 12 life here, and luckily, though, he will skate away. But back at mid, the story continues, and Weeha just, god damn it, Goblack. 17-14 Wind Ranger. Look at all those freaking denies. And now they're going to put on the moves here. They got a Nightmare setup, Power Shot, right click, Sap, you're done. This is a hard start for Weeha right now.
Honestly, as a Shadow Fiend, I don't think you can have a worse start than this. Not to mention the fact that because Darkseer was woodsing at the beginning and Pilot Eye was at bottom, he doesn't have any catch-up stacks at the moment.
This is tough, man. This is where you dig deep. We see some players, this is their time to shine. How many times we've seen players like Sumail at DAC get shut down on a Storm Spirit, killed 3 times within the first 3 minutes or something, and then they bounce back as MVP of the game. We'll have to see if Weeha can channel a bit of the same here, because he is certainly going to have the weights on at this point. He is handicapped, and Iceberg is just loving every precious second of it right now, man. So we'll see if they're going to be able to hold this and maintain it. Pylai die. Oops, scouts out the haste rune. Goblack says, nope, it's mine. And we'll take his business elsewhere, it seems.
A gift from the temple. Emo, I gotta say, Misery's doing a really good job in the offlane here. Of course, Pilot Eye started out in the lane, and he's now level 4 because of it at 4 minutes. But Misery's coming in, he's level 5, he's got the Soul Ring and Boots already. He's harassing out the Juggernaut so much, and highest, second highest on the CS board, actually, after the free farming Windrunner at mid. But thought at mid.
Weeha, with only his 3 CS, just gets shackled up. They're gonna put the Nightmare on. Goblack does have enough for another snap body mock body block. He got the raise. It's not going to be enough. He goes down again. Pilot Eye shows up just in time. He's hoping for a prayer that maybe he can get a thoughtful bash or something. No, not going to be happening. They're going to be able to make it away. But oh, at the same moment, bottom lane, Misery, who we've been praising for Secret, is able to get the jump. It looks like takes down the Jug. Will not be able to get away with his life, though. Always Want to Fly will be there to at least not let him escape. But hey, it's a grab for Secret nonetheless. But The hard story to watch is still this mid lane, and Weeha still at 3-1 CS, man. It is tough.
And of course, we have Slard at the top. He's level 5 against the enemy carry at level 5 as well. So, gotta say, Afterlife, if it wasn't the pressure that we saw with the cameo focus on Puppy earlier, it's definitely the fact that he's still getting the EXP at the very least. And honestly, he's getting pretty good CS too. For 14 CS against the dual lane, quite nice for him.
Is the reason, you know, Secret are kind of in this awkward laning stage just a product of the draft that they put themselves into? Was it expected to kind of go this way, or was there a reason they had to just settle for how it is now? Because, I mean, to be honest, how it is now, it's not working. I'm sure with that early pick on the Bane, you could have anticipated that there would be extra presence there in the mid lane to give you trouble, but they didn't. I mean, they opted to go for something like the Spirit Breaker. I know I'd been asking for the hero so much, but then now when you see it in action and you don't have that defensive help in the mid lane, it could be a bit of a problem.
I think this is actually a product of picking the AA. Even though AA could actually start at mid with Chilling Touch and give SF free souls that way as well, bonus right clicks, he just decided to save playing babies at first, and I do think it's a mix of both for sure.
Yeah, it does leave the supports little to be desired at this point, but once Puppy is able to throw together at least his level 6, they will have that global presence ready to go. And hey, for Pi, you know, he's got some good levels on his support. He's at level 5. We compare that over to the other side, and Nate, Mr. Goblack is still only level 4, so he's matching the quota there. But oh, bottom lane, they might be able to get a hold of Misery. They got a very nice glimpse back. He's stuck in a cage with nowhere to surge out from, so he will go down, and Ramses 666 will be getting his revenge by getting the last blow right there, and he is sporting his Proband shield, and it looks like he'll just go for a standard build up the Aquila from here on out.
Oh, and
Weehaw. Uh-oh, in trouble once more. Afterlife making a rotation in from the north. The Pylite is on hand and ready, charges in, and it will force CIS rejects back. They will not be able to engage. Weehaw, you can tell, very anxious, is just like, this time I need the assistance. And the second that trouble approaches, man, all the TPs and everyone comes right on, hands on deck.
Yeah, he definitely needed those TPs. And of course, Paladai with the good awareness, just camping the middle of the lane with a nice ward there as well, placed on the north side. So they saw a slaughter coming immediately as soon as he was down the ramp, and they really, really needed that intel as soon as possible. Of course, Slaughter, just going back to the lane, he has 5 magic stick charges. Means he can throw out another crush and possibly amp up the enemy carry in Caffeine Warrior slash Eternal Envy as soon as that's up in like 1 or 2 more creeps. So he's pretty content as well.
We'll see if that's going to be an opportunity here. It looks like bottom. CIS, they spring the trap. They're looking to rush in. They need the vision for the glimpse. Can he get it? He puts down. Can he do it now? He should have the vision there, but tried to drop the kinetic field to get that sight for the glimpse, but I guess it just didn't want to come out, and Misery will be able to make it away with his life. Top lane, as you said, did make the go in, popped the wand, popped the crush and the amp damage, but did not have enough of a follow-up to finish off Envy. We'll have to slither his way back to lane.
Again, he's still pretty happy being able to zone out the enemy carry like that, and of course Envy is okay with this as well. He has enough money for TP and he wants to refill his bottle anyway. As it stands, CIS rejects are still somewhat dominant around the map, I would say. I think the only thing that they're really wary of at this point is a Pylite charge followed by a rebuttal another strike, and he has that now. But speaking of which,
oh, not going anywhere, Pi. He tries to charge in on what he thinks is a lone little support disruptor, but no, not the case. Iceberg is nearby, catches him right into the shackle, and they are going to walk away with the kill. 5-2 now for CIS rejects, and I have to agree with you. They definitely have been controlling most of the map so far, and their net worth and XP can reflect that as they continue to just get more and more. I mean, now we're even seeing Disruptor. He's got Arcane Boots on hand. This has been a free lane for Jug on the bottom, which is wonderful for him. He's got his Phase Boots already in order. And for Iceberg, I mean, he's already got enough for his first component of Ags if that's what he's looking to rush for.
Now we see Misery rotating mid and charge on bottom. It's a smoke charge, so it is going to be one that's committed to a kill, I think. PL is also smoked, and I think he ported it in as well, which means that they're going for this Juggernaut for sure, and a pause comes out right on the time. Is that a Radiant Ward? I think they see him.
Yeah, they do. They do, and it's a what feels like a very damn convenient pause as it is. When we look over the vision, Secret don't quite see except for the charge radius, but definitely Jug does, and already a rotation is going to be coming in to respond to this. But they got the Nether Strike. There's always one to fly, and now he lands a beautiful two-man catch on a Static Storm and a Kinetic Field. Put the Omni Slash on top of it, and you have a 2-for-0 trade going the way of CIS Rejects. Now, unfortunate timing on the pause. At the same moment, Iceberg gets his hands on Wii, who's just trying to recover in the jungle. Oh, it goes from bad to worse now. I mean, I don't want to be too much of a conspiracy kind of a guy, but that pause was a little too good to be true at the time it was, and it allowed for a quick and prompt rotation from Always Want to Fly. Now, he is a competent support, and he may have been just that quick regardless, I'm not going to say, but in the end, it's Secret who'll just lose so much.
Yeah, and the funny thing is, the whole puppy pause segment there, it was actually initiated by Eternal Envy.
Oh.
So, yeah, it's like he paused as soon as his smoke broke under the ward there. And Paladin now recognizing this, he wards the bottom lane ward. Of course, he died mid earlier, and I don't think he recognized that ward because it's still alive, but I think he should have been able to predict that that ward must have been placed for them to make a move like that. Regardless, Weehaw also goes down in the jungle, as you saw afterwards, with the Windranger just coming in with a shackle. Didn't latch on a tree, but it was a simple focus fire into a power shot. And man, the map dominantly in favor of CIS rejects now, I gotta say.
We'll see if Secret are going to somehow find a way to get themselves back in control of it. Iceberg, who makes his presence known in the mid lane, been doing some work on this tier 1 tower, urges Misery to show up. Misery is getting pretty close to his mech, it looks like, but do Secret have a lineup that's going to be ready to go once this mech is online? I don't think so. I mean, Misery even needs a little bit more time. He only has the one level in the vacuum, doesn't have anything into his wall yet. They do have Ice Blast ready to go from Puppy, but Weehaw is certainly not where he needs to be at this point in the game to, you know, be a problem. Normally by now we're seeing Weehoff start building up that first component or something towards like his Shadow Blade, let's say, but you know, for right now he's just gonna need a bit more time. Mm-hmm. They might go on the top lane though.
Yeah. Can he get the crush? Can he get the sprint?
Well, he's got the sprint off and that's all it takes. Early preemptive rotation from Secret's not gonna lead to any bloodshed at all.
Oh, and bottom lane.
Oh, Static Storm setup. Oh, Envy rotates in, and it's another Omni Slash onto him. Last hit's gonna come onto the tower, and now it's just Pylite Eye left behind here as he gets goes back. And well, they will not have anything to stop him from this charge though, so he'll make it out with his life. But it's a big takedown, dropping the PL. And this is a CIS Rejects team who's peaking earlier than they would even like, so it's just getting better and better for them.
Better and better indeed, and honestly, this is a product of what happens when supports get level 6 before the 10-minute mark. A lot of times, people just don't expect it. And all these ultimates, this is the second time at 12 minutes that this Disruptor was able to use an ultimate and land a carry kill, and last time it was a carry plus a support. So, it's just so much efficiency value coming out of these levels on these supports, and as you mentioned, Goldblack was a little bit behind. Everything he did early on was totally worth it because it gave that Windranger a head start, and she's now level 10, hitting 2-0 and 2 and goes for a Blink Dagger right after Point Booster.
Man, it's just... And it just can't help but fall back to just Secret putting themselves in a position where with the supports they lined up, they were not able to offer a whole lot of assistance to Wii and CIS Rejects with their lineup. They don't even need to recognize that. They were just going along with their game plan and it just made it that much easier for them in the mid lane. And you were hoping at least that because of that, everyone else was able to get something more from it from the side of Secret. But you know, now we're seeing Envy go down. He's 0-2-0. You know, he's not gonna be online for a fight anytime soon. You're looking at Windranger here, who's I think already got two. Oh, that's a Blink Dagger? Is that for her?
Yep.
Who's that Blink Dagger for? Blank. Oh my goodness. Yeah, she is farmed and now she has that much more setup potential or even Radiant disengage. It's just, I don't know. This is going to be a tough mid phase here for Secret.
Juggernaut just coming in to spin the creep wave and care of the Iron Shells. They'll be able to take down this tier 1 tower. In the meantime, at top,
they're trying to make a go on this tower, but Afterlife is waiting for help to show up. He waits out. There's going to be the pump fake for the Doppelganger, and that means Envy's going to be stuck alone, and there's a Static Storm and a Kinetic Field waiting for him. Even a Fiend's Grip coming out from the Birthday Boy just to secure that one. Puppy will get a small hit onto... Oh, what a beautiful glimpse coming out, and it's onto Weehaw of all people. Always want to fly. Beautiful setup. He's awarded with the kill on a killing spree for his Disruptor this game. And CIS Rejects just continue to punish Secret 11-2 now. And I gotta tell you, even from the games we've seen in the last 2 days, oh no, mid lane Puppy caught out. And this is now the Blink Dagger on Afterlife. He puts it right to use. Luckily, Pi is gonna be here. They're gonna get out the Nether Strike, and it looks like they'll be able to get this grab. But no, Iceberg shows up, latches on with a Shackle here, and might be able to get Pi as well. A double kill going that way. 3 seconds, he got another power shot. Ramsey's looking to chase on in. He does have an Omni Slash body blocks for the crush. Let in from Afterlife.
No.
Ramsey's, it's going to be an Omni Slash between the two. They're going to get one. They could get Envy down again. Will they get it? 3 seconds, 2 seconds for a power shot. Doppelganger, he wants to shoot it. Can he land it on Envy? Oh, shoot it, boy. Shoot it. No, he's not going to. He just wants to try to make it out, but he's not going to make it away. The raises come through from Weehaw, and what a bloodbath coming out here for CIS Rejects. How many kills did they scrap together there at the end? I want to say 4? And they lose only their Windranger now. Top lane, they do land a pretty nice Ice Blast. Charges out, but looks like they will cancel it.
Yeah, against these two defensive supports, we can now Glimpse Back, Nightmare, Brain Sap, and wait out durations of the Ice Blasts. It's so much for them to handle for the time, especially without the Iron Shell from Darkseer. So they're just gonna retreat for the time being, and yeah, man, that engagement as a whole, I really thought the Windrunner was gonna get out of that. That last click from the tower really, really snatched on her, but I don't know. That was a really, really close call, and of course, if she got out, it would have been that much better for the meantime.
Weehaw looks to be going down again. Yep, they made the jump crush, and they had a Static Storm, man. Every one of those storms has been beautiful and has counted and led to some sort of destruction here. And again, the Shadow Fiend. 0-5-1 for him. Envy 0-3-1. I don't know if I've ever seen them.
It really does seem like, yeah, it really does seem like Secrets are looking a little bit shaky, but honestly, a lot of people came into this match, and I personally myself, I'm not gonna lie, I came to this series thinking that CIS Rejects, I haven't seen them in a while. Last time I saw this Iceberg guy was in the previous patch when he played Storm Spirit, and that was pretty good, but against Secret, you know, who widely considered one of the best teams in the world right now, I didn't think it was gonna be that close of a matchup, and here we are, 15-3.
I mean,
is this the effect of the birthday?
I don't even, yeah, right? What a birthday wish for him. But
yeah.
Coming after the Frankfurt Major, if you told me this was going to be one of Secret's, you know, first games, I would have been like, oh, that's an easy 90-10 odds, mm-hmm. you know, probably for Secret. But, you know, you give the last couple of days and how shaky it's been, maybe it's, I haven't personally checked it out before the series today and it might be still up, but I'd say even still, it should be like, what, 75-25 favorite for Secret? Well, as it is right now, they are looking like huge underdogs in performance. And, well, CIS Rejects are just kind of playing a stellar game at this point. They're going to make a swift go at the Roche. It looks like it's not going to be too much trouble. They have a medallion ready to go. It looks like they do. No, no, they don't.
Oh, here's the fight, maybe.
Well, this could be a disaster here for Secret if it does not go well. Committed Omni slash Static Storm is going to zone them back. They're going to get the first kill, which is on Pi. Fiend's Grip, destruction on the Weehaw right now. Puppy's going to have to just dish out an Ice Blast with that power shot. Hustling on through. Looks like Windranger trying to get the back lines. While Envy does the same, they're going to be able to take down Gobblack, but here we go. Back the other way, it's still going to be CIS who have much more at the ready. And look at this. If they can get a glimpse back, which they will, they got a hold of Envy. Bring him right into a kinetic field. A spin, a crush. He will go down. 42 seconds. Does have a buyback here.
Oh, he's just going to die, Iceberg. He just wanted to die and let the Aegis go. Actually, he's pinging out Afterlife. Maybe he thought Afterlife was going to tank the last creep hit for him. But he was at 2 HP, just walked back into the creep wave. And again, it cost him the Aegis and the Bane. But 4 kills out of that.
Yeah.
Pretty happy with that.
And now they are going to just rotate it towards the mid lane and go right for the tier 2. And perfect positioning by them. That Ice Blast not going to hit onto anyone except the creeps.
Oh, Pi.
And look,
oh,
Pi is just like, I want a party.
I
don't think he was old enough for that party, though. He just goes down. Oh, man. CIS Rejects are going to be a clean out this tier 2. And you're looking at 20-4 for CIS Rejects and over a 12k net worth and XP advantage. Who'd have thunk?
20-4.
Well, we got to start, you know, begging the question here, Clairvoyance. Is it CIS Rejects playing one hell of a game, or is it Secret not playing their A game?
Oh, man, that's a whole new can of worms, Caudle.
Yeah,
I don't know.
I mean, I got to lean a little towards the latter, I'd have to say. It's not like I've been able to watch a whole lot of CIS Rejects, but, I mean...
This is definitely something that I did not expect. I'll tell you at least that much. And, you know, this is game one of the birthday. Hold that thought.
Ice Blast might be able to get the pullback. No. Afterlife's going to be able to make it away from it. Pilot Eye, in the meantime, gets caught up with the Fiend's Grip. Will be going down. Envy's thinking about taking a fight here, but it's not one he can win. Barely able to make it out with a doppelganger, and boom! He'll go down. Ramsey's going to get the last chop on him.
Oh,
and
dude,
now Weeha struggling to make it away here. I mean, we might even see the Tau go in here. I mean, another bring down to him. It's a 5-man wipe onto Secret. I wonder if CIS Rejects are even surprised by this. They still have to go all the way back and get a tier 1 top lane. I mean, this is just them taking control of the whole map. Nowhere is safe for Secret, and they just continue to bully him.
Man, the Euro scene is a complete mess, I gotta say. With OG losing like 2-3 back-to-back series, and Secret losing like all these games that you normally wouldn't expect them to lose. In the meantime, Vega coming out strong after getting booted out from the tournament early mm-hmm. on in initial stages, and CIS Rejects now coming in. Who protected these guys in the first place, I wonder? I don't know. This is way too many questions.
And again, I say Secret need this win. They need at least a 2-0 or a 2... I mean, even if it's a 2-1 for Secret, they're still in fourth. That's not good enough. They need every win they can get here if they want to not have to go through that last chance. And it looks like it might happen. Envy again going to be caught out and taken down. Nowhere is safe for him to go and farm. He tries to make it work in his woods, but CIS Rejects are still around, still just as aggressive as ever. And after taking on that tier 1 top, they're going to follow up with a tier 2 now. And the rich just get richer, Clairvoyance. 20k net worth advantage for them. We're looking at supports that are just holding the mightiest of items, a Yule's picked up for a certain always want to fly disruptor. Dire structures And now they're sieging high ground, and I don't think Secret are gonna have much of an answer for it. With maybe Misery with one hell of a vacuum wall.
Yeah, maybe this is the last ditch effort kind of thing here. Here we go.
Move in, walls drop, but now a static storm will zone him back so he can't get off a proper vacuum, and just like that, Pilot Eye's dead. Static Storm was committed for this. A swing and a miss comes out from Afterlife trying to get a hold of Puppy. Now tier 3 is gonna be going now. What a vacuum, possibly to an Ice Blast! That's pretty damn good, but I don't think it's gonna be good enough. Misery tries to pop off the mech and make it back in a way, but he will be going down. Weehaw with a Requiem, but it is a miss for him. The rest of CIS Rejects have already backed themselves out and away from the trouble. They are gonna put on a reformation and re-engage, but there's no point to it. Says Secret, they throw in the towel. It's all over. CIS Rejects will get the first win.
CIS Rejects, man, they made this look way easier than it against Secret. I don't know what else to say. They really did play wonderfully from minute one. They had the lanes down pat. They had the strategy laid out for them with the Bane harassment from the birthday boy himself, and of course the